Hey, GBC family, we miss you. We're praying for you. We're looking forward to being together again as soon as possible. And as our community moves towards making every effort to try to reopen and get back to normal, whatever that's going to look like, our church leadership, under the advisement of local medical professionals, we've been putting our heads together as well so we can talk about what reopening for us is going to look like. The good news is we've never actually closed. We just had to relocate for a little while. Now, any of you that have a relationship with Grace Bible and its leadership, know that we value the capital C Church above all else. And with that said, we feel that it may be helpful to mention a few things that may help you understand why we have arrived at the conclusions that we have. To the glory of God, GBC is one of the largest regular occurring single gatherings in our community of any type. Now, when we're all together, even in the summertime, the volume of both children and adults on campus at each of our three services is often significant. Now, while we celebrate this fact, as you might imagine, reopening while maintaining some semblance of social distancing is, well, complicated. Now, let me just be honest for a second. Churches all over the U.S. are trying to figure out how to get back to normal as quickly as possible, but the American church, it can't afford to go back to what we call normal, where we only exist on Sunday mornings and Wednesday nights as we pile into our buildings on every street corner and shut the door to the world. The kingdom of God is too powerful. The gospel is too wonderful. And our king is too great. Our calling is too sure to simply go back to that when all of this is over. Now, while large gatherings on Sundays and Wednesdays are important, kingdom citizens have to introduce new rhythms into their lives to take the good news of Jesus outside of the church buildings, into our neighborhoods and our schools and our workplaces. As a church, we're committed to see that through by equipping our folks with the right tools to help us grow in being disciples of Jesus while we are learning to go and make disciples of Jesus in the everyday stuff of life. So why don't we start right here, right now, with this opportunity that the Lord has dropped in our lap? With all that said, here's what we've decided to do for our phase one. For the next four weekends in the month of May, our sermon series is going to be called Home, Where the Church Thrives the Most. As we open up Deuteronomy 6 together and look at God's call on His people to make their homes their primary mission station, we want to begin to assemble the church body together again by starting at your house. Yes, your house. Whether you choose to do it indoors or outdoors, for the next 4 weeks, we invite you to turn your home into a mission station, inviting neighbors, both churched and unchurched, over for breakfast on Sunday mornings and sitting down to watch the weekend service together. Now, we're going to provide some simple discussion guides to go along with the sermons to help you prompt some gospel conversations right in your living room with the people that God has planted nearest to you as the missionary that you are. While it goes without being said, please make every effort to do all of these things using wisdom concerning the safety and health of your family, as well as those that you will invite into your home, being mindful that we are still in the wake of a pandemic. While this is happening, we will be looking towards June 7th. June 7th is a hopeful reopening date for our large gatherings. We don't know exactly what that's going to look like yet or what variables may change over the next several weeks, but we will be daily and diligently planning towards that end if the current state of affairs continues to move in a positive direction as it has been. We will be sure to keep you posted in the coming weeks as we know more. Though we are all so eager to get back together, our elder team is unified without exception on this plan moving forward. And we love you all. We look forward to seeing what the Lord is going to do through all of this. And we are praying for you. We can't wait to be together again soon.